Hi there. In this tutorial, I want to talk about one particular element of the scene you can see. So that is the reflections in this pool. So this scene is an Eevee scene, which means there are some limitations in terms of how light works in it. It isn't as natural as light in the Cycles render engine. But there is a couple of little tricks you can do to make it more useful and look better. So you can see here we've got reflections of these lights here, and you can see there's a reflection of the moon. The water has got some slight ripples on it, so even the reflections of these trees are slightly distorted. But with this technique, you can create an actual mirror in Eevee if that's what you want to do. So if we look at the scene, I've got a basic little forest created here. There's a pool and a stream running through the middle, and I've got some lights, and I have a mesh which is representing the moon and some particles and what have you. So I've removed a couple of things from this scene, and we'll just go to preview render now. And you can see it is working. We are getting reflections in the pool down here, but they're not very good ones. So I'm going to simplify this scene by just turning my geometry nodes off. Just creating an awful lot of the scene. So that's now previewing a little more quickly. I'm also going to select the water. I've just got a plane here, which is representing the water. And I'm just going to remove the texture inputs that are giving the sort of roughness to the surface or ripples on the surface. We've now got a completely flat plane for the water, and yet you can still see it's very distorted. It's not a very good mirror, as it were, at all. And if I try and move things around, you can just about see there's a reflection of the moon there. But it's not very good at all. And that's even with screen space reflections turned on. So by default, they're turned off. And you can see if I turn that off there in Eevee settings, there's no reflections at all. So obviously we need that on, but it's still not a very good reflection. By default, half res trace will be on. Turning that off, which effectively increases the quality of reflections and refractions, may improve it slightly. And you can play around with these settings, but basically you're not going to get a perfect mirror. Can't even see these stars reflected down here without one additional thing. And that's really what this tutorial's about. So I'm going to add, under light probe, a reflection plane, which you may not have used before. I'm just going to come out of rendered view to do this. So there is my reflection plane, and I'm just going to scale it up a little bit just so that it encloses the whole thing. Now, the most important thing here is that my reflection plane, you'll notice it has a sort of thickness. It has multiple little levels there. That's sort of indicating the area of influence for this reflection plane. I'm just going to hide the landscape now so that all that we're left with is the plane, which is the water, and of course the reflection plane. So I'm going to scale it up a little bit and then scale on the X just to shrink that back a bit. So we've enclosed the water in that direction, and we can see we just need to lower it a little bit, and you can now see that the reflection plane is around the water. It's not really a cube, but it just has multiple layers, and you just need to make sure that they enclose the object that you want to be mirror-like. So what it's probably worth doing once you've done that is select the reflection plane, select the, in this case, water surface, Control P and say Object Keep Transform, and now when I move the water around, the reflection plane will move with it. So let's have a look now. So all I've done is just added the reflection plane. I haven't changed any settings. Once you've grouped it, of course, if you want to select the reflection plane, you'll need to go to the object, in this case I've called it water, that you've parented it to, and then you'll find it in there, and I can now select it. And I can now click here to go and look at the settings. I played around with them slightly. I set mine to 0.25 distance, so that essentially thickens this area up a little bit, the area of influence. And then you may need to just adjust the exact position of the plane. So you can see here it's not quite working correctly. But G, Z, and I'll hold the Shift key so I can move slowly. And you notice we get to a point where suddenly we get a load of reflection. So you can now see my figure there is reflected. I've still got some mist in the scene, so if I turn that mist off, we can start to see more of what's going on. And it's not perfect, it is an approximation. This is Eevee that we're using here, so it uses various cheat techniques in order to render much more quickly. But it is a better result than not using a reflection plane at all. And there we go. You can see I've got the height just right now, and we're now getting a mirror-like reflection. So if I go back to my water and put the bump map back in, now that's given me the distortion back. I could perhaps lower that a little bit. And really, that's all there is to using the reflection plane. So if I bring my whole scene back now and turn on my particles again, There we go. So I hope you found that useful. If you did, let me know. If people are interested, I can go into more detail on how I created this whole scene. Essentially, I used the sapling generator to create these fir trees and the other trees in here. I used a rock generator to generate a variety of rock, and then used geonodes to distribute the rocks and grass and things like that all around the scene, and finally put some mist on the scene. And you can even get a little bit of god rays coming in through the mist as well. And I used a little technique I've shown before to create the stars in the sky. So if you enjoyed that tutorial, please click like. If you'd like to see more about how I created this scene, please put a comment below. I try to read all the comments and answer any questions that come up. And don't forget to click subscribe. I will upload this file for my Patreon patrons to use. Otherwise, I will see you in the next tutorial. Thanks a lot.